Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we talked about the baseline express with TypeScript. We will build a proper baseline code with routes, APIs, database connections, error handlings and services and controllers. Before that we will take a look onto one example about a basic architecture, and for that basic architecture we will create a baseline microservice which will take care of the graceful shutdown, which will take care of all kind of error handling, which will take care of the database connections, starting the server on a particular port, configuration management, and TypeScript, introducing TypeScript with Express. Okay, so what we can do is, this is our user. We are going to build a simple solution, full stack application. Okay, so consider, okay, this is my user. Okay, and this user will interact with our system, and we are building a full stack application with the not just microservices. So there will be a multiple microservices taking care of the independent task. Okay, so we are doing a first of all local setup. We are not creating infrastructure how it look like on AWS Azure. We are going to build it very simple. So here we are going to have a Nginx. Okay, so Nginx will route the traffic to appropriate microservice. On the Nginx we have a proper routing. Okay, and from here we are diverting the traffic to multiple services. These are Node.js services. Okay, so we will build it like this, and it can be like authentication service, and there will be a Redis and MySQL MongoDB. Okay, I can use here for this auth service I have a Redis, and for rest I do have a MySQL. Okay, I'm fine with this icon, and these are my two different microservices, and this is having Redis. And consider that some data you are storing in the MySQL also. Okay, so this is my structure look like, and I do have a front end also which is built in React. I'm writing my front end in React.js. So this is my React.js, and React.js may be talking to auth 0, or we have our own authentication system built with the Node.js and JWT token. So all the requests, you see this user will be talking, all the requests will go to Nginx. From Nginx we will do the routing of the service to a proper channel. So here on the forward slash we will route it to, like whenever you are hitting forward slash, we will route our request to front end. Okay, now whenever you are hitting a request to API, like you are hitting a forward slash API forward slash auth, then all the requests will go to the authentication service. And whenever you are hitting a service which is the URL is consider API forward slash API v1, consider a service, and there is another service, and it is API legacy service or whatever it is. Okay, and all these services having their own database. Now you can see this particular simple example is, it's a full stack application, and you have created all these as a Docker containers to show, expose these, all these different containers. These are nothing but a different containers we have. Okay, for MySQL we have a different container, for Redis we will have a different container. Now you may have a different database, different database instance for each and every microservice. This you can call it as a cart microservice or any other microservice, and this is our Node.js auth microservice. Okay, all are on local using Docker Compose. You are running it on the Docker containers. Okay, and Docker Compose is spinning all these services. Even Nginx is also a container. We are just hitting and port 80 is exposed, and all the other communications are happening from container to container. Okay, a simple example of containerization here, and internal networking is happening because all are getting activated. All these containers are starting through one single Docker Compose file, so they are already in a single network, so they can talk to one another. MySQL, these are separate containers. Okay, and these Node.js service has the connections to these MySQL database. Here we have two different services. I have a Redis and MySQL because I wanted to cache some user level information in the Redis, so I don't need to query a database every time. Okay, this Node.js service is talking to MySQL and Redis both. Similarly, these services are talking to MySQL. Okay, so this kind of setup we can actually implement in our Docker Compose on the local stack, where front end, which is a React application, is exposing on some particular 3000 port. We have to write a Docker files for each and every service. These are already services. We just need to pull the image. For these Node.js services and React, we will be writing a Docker file and we'll be building it and starting through the Docker Compose. Okay, so that user will be able to hit the React component, React UI, and then React UI will talk to /API auth, /API service, /API legacy. Okay, now our main focus is to build these small microservice in a scalable way. I mean, we should be able to create a foolproof microservice which can deal with if needed, we can extend it with the connecting to Redis, extend it connecting to the RabbitMQ or any other microservice. So there should be a proper integration layer, proper logging, proper error handling. All these things should be happening. There can be another microservice because it's not like every time microservices are self-reliant. They are getting everything from the database. They can be talking to another external microservice, which is like this is for sending the email. Or this microservice is again talking to a central logging service, which is taking care of logging the transactions. Or it can be, and it is further talking to the MongoDB database. Okay, here I can have this as a MongoDB database. So I will just change the color. This is a MongoDB database and it's my another service, which is a logging service. This is the email notification service. This can further talk to SES for sending email, or SendGrid, or simple node mailer, right? This can be externally talking to SES service to send the email for your service. And this is a logging service, which may be doing a logging on a particular database, maybe a MongoDB documents it is creating for each and every transactions which are happening. So these microservices can be talking to another microservice. So we should be able to create a proper external interface and proper handling. If this service is down, what should be the impact on this? First of all, there should be no tight coupling of these services. If this service is down, there should be no major impact. It's like an independent feature will be down, logging, the sending the email to the user, and we should be able, the impact should be reflected on the APIs. Okay, now what we will do is we will baseline a simple microservice in the Node.js, and then we will see how we can structure these services through a Docker Compose file. Okay, let's see that in the next video. Thanks everyone.